I'm Erica Jacoby, and this is another Higher Things video short. Woke Wednesday takes on, am I in an abusive relationship? Like, subscribe, ring the bell, get the app, donate. If you love what we're doing here at Higher Things, pass it on the faith to the next generation. Like our videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel, ring the bell for notifications, get our app, and donate. Your tax-deductible gift keeps Higher Things, a youth organization that's all about the gospel. It keeps us a-rolling. Wednesdays are all about being woke, and today, like last week, the ladies are taking over. In addition to Pastor Borghardt, whose seat I've stolen, Sandra Madden is my guest today, talking about, am I in an abusive relationship? As I mentioned last week, in addition to serving as our content executive here at Higher Things, Sandra serves on the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod's Domestic Violence and Child Abuse Task Force. She is one of their featured and expert speakers, and we get to have her as our in-house expert for free. Thanks, Sandra. Welcome, Sandra, and welcome again to your own show, Pastor Borghardt.
Hey. Thank you.
This is fun. I don't know if I'm ever going to let him have this seat back, Sandra. What do you think?
Hey.
This is, your intro seems somewhat familiar. I don't know. It's very talented, I got to say. Honed over many, many years. All right, I'm getting out of the picture.
So last week, Sandra, we talked about, you defined abuse for us. I think it would be helpful again, before we get started, if you would define abuse again and maybe even either give some examples or give some of the, I know there are some nuanced versions of abuse, because I think immediately when you think about an abusive relationship, it's, oh, does he punch, or does he or she punch the other person? Do they hit them? Can you kind of talk about that?
Right. That's the common understanding of abuse or domestic violence, is that it's physical. Someone is beating the tar out of someone else, and that's abuse. It might be, it probably is. It might just be situational violence, which is also bad. So first I'm going to define abuse, because I use a very specific definition, that abuse is a deliberate pattern of behavior used by a person in an intimate relationship to intimidate his or her partner and thereby gain or maintain power and control over the other person. And this is different from situational violence, which is what you have when you have people in a relationship who have poor anger control or conflict resolution skills, and things just go back and forth and escalate and get out of control, and things just blow up and happen. Abuse is different because it's deliberate. It is totally on purpose. An abuser knows exactly what they are doing. They are not acting out of anger. They are not losing control, even though they may say, oh, I lost control. Because it doesn't happen anywhere and everywhere in front of anyone. It doesn't happen with everybody. It happens in very specific situations with very specific people. So it's deliberate. They have total control over their choices to be abusive. It's a pattern. It's predictable. There's a cycle to abuse, that there is a stress-building phase and an explosion of an abuse event, and then a honeymoon phase, and then it keeps going on and on. There is a pattern of behavior used by abusers to groom their victims from the very beginning of the relationship. It's very intentional and manipulative, and there's a definite pattern to it, where situational violence could just erupt one day because someone had a bad day at work or had a bad day at school or something like that. It's used by a person in an intimate relationship to intimidate his or her partner. The whole point of it is to cause fear. So there may or may not be actual physical violence involved, because the thing about abuse is that it escalates. What works, you know, for a little while with just kind of a veiled threat or a little hint at control or something like that, doesn't always work. The victim kind of figures things out or pushes the boundaries a little bit, and so the abuse has to change in relationship to that. And it's not until actually later on that the manipulative tactics have failed that there is often a physical event that occurs to back up the threat of the emotional, physical, or not physical, psychological threats and things like that to make it show that, yeah, they are serious. So the whole point is intimidation of the partner to gain or maintain power and control in the relationship. The thing about abusers is that they have this mentality that they are entitled to have basically life handed to them on a platter. And people that they're in relationships with, they're there to serve them and make their life easy and make sure that there's no stumbling blocks or work or anything that gets in the way of their enjoying their lives. And they can treat them like property. They can use them. They can misuse their relationship. They can control them and do whatever it takes. And in their mind, this is totally justified. And so that's why there's a pattern. And an abuser is, it's a whole different situation than just someone who's a jerk, someone who calls you names and is just a rude kind of belligerent person. It's a lot scarier than that, actually, when you think about it.
So it's not just a bad temper.
No. And so there are a lot of, as I mentioned, I think on last week's episode, you can't just go down a checklist and say, okay, yeah, he does 7 out of these 10 things, and so therefore this is an abusive relationship. It could be. But may or may not, it could just be poor anger management. The key there is, are you scared of that other person? Are you scared of what might happen if you don't do XYZ? Or if you do something that you're not supposed to do according to that person? Or are you scared to break up with them or leave the relationship? That right there is the biggest red flag that, yes, the relationship is abusive. Are you scared? Are you safe?
So that's a really good way of putting that. You mentioned that abusers groom. You mentioned that they feel entitled. Mm-hmm. Obviously, right now we're talking about romantic relationships or marriage, yeah. Or kids is kind of a different situation because they can't leave, of course, until they grow up. But one of the biggest questions I think that comes up is, why don't, and I'll just say women in this case, understanding that happens a little more frequently with women, but it can happen with men. But why don't they just leave? Why don't they just walk away?
A lot of reasons. First of all, yes, it does happen to men. Men are frequently victims of abuse by women. We don't have a lot of statistics on that. There's also a lot of abuse that goes on in same-sex relationships and alternative-type relationships. They're not exempt either. But why doesn't the victim leave? Well, first of all, that's the wrong question to ask, because it puts responsibility for the relationship continuing or the abuse going on onto the victim rather than on the person who's actually causing the abuse in the relationship. The better question to ask is, why is the abuser allowed to continue to abuse? Why is nobody else seeing it? But that said, there are a lot of reasons why victims don't leave. A lot of times they don't even realize that they are in an abusive relationship. I know for myself, I didn't realize it until my life was literally being threatened. I was in danger. I did not realize that. Denial is a very powerful thing that we are able to do to ourselves. And if there's not overt physical beatings going on, like we are conditioned to see abuse as, or domestic violence as, we may just write it off. There are all sorts of sociological factors that there may be children in the relationship that makes it difficult. There's financial abuse that makes it difficult to actually go anywhere and have money to pay for somewhere to stay or get to work or childcare or food or things like that. You actually may be legitimately scared that you will be killed And the most dangerous time for a victim is when they actually do decide and attempt to leave, because the abuser has lost control. They have lost control, and so therefore the abuse has to escalate accordingly in order to get control back, and that may mean something as serious as murder happens. Murder-suicides are often, almost always even, abusive relationships. And then they may threaten to kill themselves or injure themselves or threaten family members, pets. And so these things are very real. And as women, like it or not, we are conditioned to be agreeable, to work on our relationships, to sacrifice, to put ourselves last, to nurture and see the best in people and do all these things. And that is something that abusers take advantage of. And so that's another reason that victims don't always leave.
Okay. So we're almost out of time today. We are going to go another week. However, I would like, as we've talked here about, am I in an abusive relationship? I'm going to ask both of you this question. Sandra, where can somebody go for more information and to get help?
There are tons of websites online. Make sure that you're using a safe computer, that your history is not being tracked. If you are at all concerned about being in an abusive relationship, borrow a friend's phone, borrow a friend's computer, whatever. Just search for domestic violence and signs. And there are many ways, physical, sexual, financial, emotional, all sorts of different things that you might not have realized were abuse that actually are. Pastor.
So the important thing to remember here is it's not your fault. I would go to your pastor and I would confess your sins, because even me telling you it's not your fault isn't going to fix it. You're still going to believe it's your fault. And so be forgiven for where you failed. There's no sort of change that you can make, no thing that you can tweak, no conditioning. That was an interesting word you said there, Sandra. Conditioning that you can have in order to make this better. We have to sort of come to grips with sin and its consequences, and how we sort of deal with that within the church is our next week topic, right?
Yes, it
right. is. Right. All right. That, I mean, that's my, the forgiveness is in Christ. The only comfort is in Christ. I really don't believe the idea that you're going to sort of change and tweak the thing, your life, that in order that the abuser is going to be less abusive. Mm-hmm. Is only going to bring more abuse. It's a cycle. And so, that's next week, because we've run out of time. At least if I were hosting this, we would have run out of time already. Bye.
Do I get to do my spiel? Okay. I get to close it out today. Thanks for joining us today on Woke Wednesday Takes on Am I in an Abusive Relationship? I'm Erica Jacoby, and this has been another Higher Things video short.